Three of the big four banks are predicting a rate rise could still happen when the Reserve Bank meets on Tuesday. That's despite latest data showing inflation has fallen sharply to 5.6%. To discuss, we're joined by Research Director at RateCity.com.au, Sally Tindall. Sal, good morning. Thanks for your time again. So given inflation is easing, why wouldn't the RBA press pause?
Well, there's another line ball call coming on Tuesday's meeting, but let's look at all the data together. Retail sales, it went up 0.7%. People are still spending at the shops after 12 RBA hikes. Unemployment, it dropped 3.7 down to 3.6%. That gives the RBA cover to fire off another hike if they want to. And then the big one, as you suggested, inflation, it's down from 6.8 to 5.6. However, you peel back the layers and it's not as sunny as it appears on the surface. When you exclude volatile items, they're the things that go up and down like petrol and food, it actually only went from 6.5 to 6.4%. And that will have the RBA worried. So if you add all of those things up, I think we can say on paper it looks like another hike, particularly because the RBA has this now or never approach to hiking the cash rate at the moment.
It just makes for more anxiety out there in the community. And I dare say it, rates could go even higher.
Yes.
What does your crystal ball sort of suggest?
Well, let's look at the big four banks' crystal balls.
Yeah.
You know, it's a good start. CBA, as you said, they are expecting no hike on Tuesday, but they think one more is coming. That'll take it to 4.35%. ANZ, NAB, Westpac, they all think hike on Tuesday, hike again in August, 4.6%. I think if you've got a mortgage, plan for that 4.6.
So plan now.
Plan now for that 4.6 because the way we're tracking, it could happen.
How much is it going to cost mortgage holders?
A lot.
Yeah.
Okay, so a hike on Tuesday is $77 for someone with a $500,000 mortgage. Another hike in August, another $77 across 14 hikes at that point in time. If it gets to 4.6, you're looking at $1,288 extra on your mortgage. If the cash rate stays at 4.6 for the next 12 months, you're looking at over $15,000 extra in after-tax dollars. And of course, on a million-dollar debt, it's double the pain. You're looking at a total of $30,000 over the next 12 months if there's two more hikes.
It's not lying around, that sort of cash.
The problem is deposits, money in the bank from households, just hit another record high. What is going on here? $1.38 trillion stashed in the bank. This is a huge buffer, but as you and I both know, that buffer is not spread equally. Some people are still squirreling money away. Some people are still spending at the shops, and many, many others are struggling to make ends meet.
Hey, Sal, nearly all of the major banks have now scrapped these cashback deals. Is it still worth refinancing?
Yeah, OK. So the big four banks, they're walking away from refinancing as fast as their feet will take them. You've got ANZ still offering cashback, but they're the only ones and, you know, there's a target on that, I'd say. They've also hiked new customer rates a total of 16 times in the last 4 months. 16 times. We've been crunching new customer versus existing customer rates for years. Let me tell you, that's not normal. But that doesn't mean it's not worth refinancing. You may just have to look beyond the big four banks. If you refinance, if there's a hike on Tuesday, we expect the average owner-occupier to be around 7.11%. 7.11%. But if they can refinance down to about 5.75%, which we think will still be available even with one more hike, they could save over $12,000 over the next 2 years, even when you factor in switch costs. It would drop their monthly repayments immediately by over $400. This is on a $500,000 loan. It's absolutely worth it to refinance if you can.
The bottom line, though, as we sit this morning, prepare now.
Absolutely.
Just in case.
Just prepare. Yep.
Sally Tindall, thanks as always.